So you probably heard by now, but a study just came to light that showed in 2012, Facebook manipulated nearly 700,000 news feeds. So what did they do? They toyed with your emotion. The premise of the study was this rumor that every time you look at Facebook and it seems like your friends are just living these amazing lives, you get a little bit depressed. So these data scientists at Facebook, they wanted to put that to the test. Now, they actually found quite the opposite. People are posting positive things, you end up posting positive things. But here's where things get a little bit sticky. In order to do that, they essentially manipulated user emotions. So this kind of brings to light that question, is this ethical? Well, I hate to break it to you, and I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but this is nothing new. Big tech companies do this sort of thing all the time. They are constantly collecting data. Facebook has over 1 billion users. This is one of the richest pools of data you can possibly imagine. So for us to think that Facebook wouldn't be doing these types of tests and trying to analyze all different types of data points, it'd be absurd. Now, here in this particular case, there's also this question of ethics, which is a chance for us to take a step back and look and see that a lot of tech companies are trying to find creative ways to use this data. We live our lives online. Google, Amazon, Twitter, Facebook, they have all taken note. I think it's safe to say everything we do online is being tested. Every time you click, I agree to the terms of service, whether it's on Facebook, whether it's Twitter, you are actually handing over a lot of your data and you're saying, I can be a guinea pig. Facebook's terms of service has something like 9,000 words. A lot of folks aren't going to read through, and even if you do read through, sometimes it's iffy to know what exactly Facebook is going to do with your data. You know, as we live our lives more online, as we give more and more permission, and as tech companies get smarter and utilize data, these are questions we're going to be asking ourselves, and that's something we're probably going to face a lot in the future. And it's not just Facebook, it's Twitter, it's Amazon, it's all these different tech companies that are trying to make money off of us and trying to understand us a little bit better.